In fact, Allah shows what we are. Allah appears to test what we are, but that is not actually the case. Looked at it in terms of ilm al-ladun, the knowledge of divine providence, that is not the case. Because Allah knew what we would do. He has sent us to paradise or to hell. So there is actually no question of being tested, of Allah investigating and learning about us. Allah already knows about us. He shows us to ourselves, shows us what we are. And we will experience the joy of that in paradise. We will say, we rendered such and such a service, did this and that, but in fact, it is Allah who engages in these deeds. For example, you are now exhibiting virtuous behavior and inshallah you will go to paradise. If I see you have gone to paradise, then Allah willing, I will love you even more there. Because I will see the sacrifices you have made. I will see your virtues and lovable nature. I will know them in this world. Since I will go there with that knowledge, it will remain with me forever, and I will therefore love you forever with that knowledge. For example, one has a spouse, one sees their moral virtue, and that stays with one forever. That's why a man loves his wife more than he does huris. It is because of that knowledge, because he has seen her altruism, her courage, her fortitude, her kindness, her religious observances, and all other kinds of behavior. Since he has absorbed that information, it will remain with him for all eternity, and he will also love that knowledge. But that's not the case with huris. He sees no virtue in huris in this world. Huris have to be virtuous in the hereafter. That's why people love their wives far more in the hereafter, because they see much more manifestations of Allah in her. They are in a more acceptable position. For example, our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, refers to himself and adds Hamza, peace be upon him, Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, and Hazrat Ali, peace be upon him, and the companions, saying, we are the Sayyid, that is the lords of the people of paradise. Why? Because they all suffered. We will love them for that in the hereafter. Why do we admire the Prophet Joseph, peace be upon him, so much in the hereafter? Because he suffered hardship. Why do we admire the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him? Because he suffered hardship. Because they displayed a powerful love of Allah, because they felt such an intense and fervent love. For example, when we look at the gardens of paradise, we will lose our senses from love. The same is with its furniture, food and drink. But the truth of the matter is that all of these things will be bestowed as images. But people will not know they are images. They will be bestowed in the greatest clarity. One will be unable even to wonder whether they might be mere images. Nobody will have the power to do that. But these things will be given as images. They will exist on the outside, but that's how people will perceive them. They will perceive them in their brains, heads and souls. But the originals, matter, will exist on the outside in paradise. The original of matter does exist in the outside world. Our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, says the mansions of paradise resemble crystal. People move in and out of them. There are small streams all around, small streams of paradise. Paradise consists of layers. Paradise consists of perfect houses, more beautiful than one can ever imagine. We are given a glimpse in this world. The houses of this world are still created in our brains, and the dwellings of paradise will also be created in our brains. The birds and animals of paradise, everything will be created in our brains. We can never have direct experience of the original of paradise. There is an original, external paradise, but we will always experience the images of it.